welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about my running story and how I started running, what I do now for running, and my tips for beginners, because I think they might be helpful to people that want to start out running but don't know how or don't know what they should have or anything like that, so I'll go into that. I just want to obviously point out that I am not a professional runner. I'm not a professional in any sort, so you should take my tips with a pinch of salt. You should obviously consult your doctor if you're thinking about starting running and whether you're healthy and your joints and all that kind of stuff can handle running. I'll talk about how I got into running first. So I, as a child, wasn't very active. I hated PE. I think that was partially because I was overweight, so it's not something that appealed to me really, and I always felt really embarrassed when I was running and doing any sort of exercise in front of anyone else. Cross country and anything that involved running, I just didn't like at all. So obviously the weight piled on. I've got obviously my video on weight loss, and after I'd lost a bit of weight, I eventually started running. So I used the C to 5K program, which is the Couch to 5K, which was, I think, created by NHS, but don't take my word for it. It might have been started by someone else, but that's what I used. I started that in February of 2011 or 2012, I can't quite remember the dates exactly, but I started that in February, and it's supposed to get you running from being on the couch to running 5k in 9 weeks. So I started that. I did the runs consistently, took the breaks when I needed them, and the first run was hard and I almost gave up straight away. But you just have to keep pushing yourself. It's one of those things where you just have to keep pushing your boundaries. I did that, did my runs consistently. Within 6 weeks, I think it jumped quite significantly between the running intervals, because C to 5K is walk-run intervals. So it'll have you running a certain distance and then walking for a certain distance or a certain amount of time. After 6 weeks, I think it took a really big jump. It went from running like 5 minutes to running 20 minutes. And in that time, I just decided to go for it. And on the 6 week mark, I managed to run 5K without stopping. I decided to stop C to 5K after that and just continue to do my own thing. So since then, I've been running 3 times a week, obviously. Busyness permitting and stuff like that, but usually it's 3 runs a week. I usually do 2 short runs during the week and then 1 long run on the weekend when I've got more time, and that's just consistently what I've been doing since I started running. So obviously there's speed runs and interval runs and all that kind of stuff, but I won't get into that now. It's just my general story of how I got into running. Running has been like pretty essential for my weight loss, really. I mean, I lost a lot of weight before then, but I don't think I'd have been able to lose all the rest of the weight without the running included. But obviously running isn't just for weight loss. People do it for fun. People do it for whatever reasons they want. But for me, it was for weight loss. Obviously now I'm not losing weight anymore, so I just do running for fun, and just to keep my fitness up. That's pretty much it. So I went from being a kid that really, really hated running to someone that still kind of hates running, but I do it to improve my fitness levels, so that's that. Now, anyone that wants to get into running or is thinking about getting into running or is a beginner and maybe needs some tips, then I will share some of my tips with you that I used. So my first tip is to get do a gait analysis. Now, a gait analysis is where you go on a treadmill and someone assesses your running and sees how your feet land on the treadmill and how your legs are aligned and all that kind of stuff, and they will recommend a certain shoe depending on whether your feet roll outwards or inwards, whether you're flat footed or whether you've got high arc. They'll either recommend supported shoe or cushioned shoes. So that, I think that's definitely an essential part. If you don't get your shoes fitted properly, it can cause injuries, it can cause blisters. If you don't get the right size, it can be awful. Trust me, I've done it. I just ran in basic trainers and they pretty much ruined my feet from the off. So get gait analysis. You can do that at stores like Sweatshop, DW Sports. Any kind of independent running store usually has a gait analysis and treadmill. Definitely get a gait analysis. That's the one thing that I recommend for anyone that's going to start out running. It's also important to have the right gear. So you'll need crocs, shorts, technical t-shirts like sweat wicking t-shirts, maybe a running bottle, running socks, because if you run it in just normal socks you can get blisters and all that kind of stuff, and you really really don't want them. I think that's it. T-shirts, shorts, socks are pretty much the main essentials for running. People always say running is really expensive, and yes, it is really expensive at the start, but not so much when you've got into running, because when you've already got the gear and the trainers and everything else, you don't tend to need to keep getting it all the time. You usually only get it when things wear out, when your trainers have done a certain amount of miles, or when like thread is hanging off your t-shirts and you can't wear them anymore. But other than that, you don't really have any recurring costs that are just constant. It's usually maybe every month or every other month you have to buy something new. Then the next tip is to have a plan. So obviously I said that I'd done the C2 5K, so there's apps for C2 5K, there's the podcasts. I'd probably not recommend the podcasts now, because when I did it, I think C2 5K might have been quite new, so the podcasts were only available. But now they have apps, so the apps, you start the app, it starts your running, walking intervals, and then I think you can listen to music in the background, whereas when I did the podcast, I couldn't have any music in the background. I just had to listen to their crappy music. Have some sort of plan. So plan out how many runs you're going to do per week. That's pretty important. The more you know about what you're going to do during the week, the more you'll have the motivation to do them, and you'll know exactly which runs that you're going to go out for and when you're going to rest and all that kind of stuff. Plan which days you're going to run and what are going to be your rest days, because obviously you need rest days. I typically take a rest day in between each run, so usually my schedule is Monday and Tuesday I don't have a run, then Wednesday I usually have a run, then Thursday I'm off, then Friday I'll have a run, and then Saturday I'll either do a shorter run or I'll have a rest, and then Sunday is usually my long run, and then obviously it continues again Monday and Tuesday is a rest. My next tip is to make sure that you warm up properly and that you cool down properly. This is something that I quite slack on really, but it's definitely something that I recommend for others. So warm-ups should be like dynamic stretches, going for like a 5-minute walk before you start running. It's just so it elevates your heart rate, gets all your muscles warmed up before you go into like more strenuous activities, and cool down afterwards. So maybe after you've finished your run, then do a 5-minute cool down walk, and then afterwards don't forget to stretch. This is something that I sometimes miss out on, and I don't stretch properly, and then you definitely feel it the next day. Your legs can feel tight. It really aids in your recovery after your run, so definitely stretches. I might do another video on that if people are interested in what kind of stretches you do before and after a run, then just let me know and I'll make a video on that. My next tip is don't forget to rest and listen to your body. If your body is telling you that it's too tired, your run's not really going to go that well. Make sure you take the rest, like I mentioned earlier, have a rest in between each run. You don't have to do that, you can probably do two runs and then a rest, but definitely make sure you rest in between. I think it's really important for recovery. Rest is pretty much just as important as the actual run or the exercise that you're doing. It helps to recover and rebuild your muscles during the time that you're not running. So definitely make sure you rest. So the last tip is for those who are uncomfortable or nervous or don't have as much confidence to go out and run outside. All I can advise is just to ignore them. A majority of the time, I mean, I was the same when I was overweight and I started running. I was worried constantly of what other people would think of me and whether people would make comments or anything like that. You really just have to ignore people. A majority of the time, people ignore you anyway. They don't really see you, they don't say anything. I've never had a rude comment said to me on the street, even when I was overweight. To me, it's more inspirational to see someone running outside rather than just, you know, thinking of someone sat on a couch eating crisps all day and being really unhealthy. So try and look at the positives and what running is going to do for you, and that's it really. If you're nervous or scared of that side of things, then you could listen to music, put your headphones in, you won't be able to hear anyone shouting. You can wear like sunglasses and a hat, just so people don't recognise you when you're on the street, if you're scared of people recognising you running. With that, also if you're nervous, you can join a running club. Running clubs usually tailor for all running types, people that are slower, people that are faster, people that have never run before, beginners, intermediates to advanced runners. So there's something for everyone in a running club. There's just a good way to socialise and have everyone be in the same place that is doing the same thing. They could help people that are low in confidence, that don't really want to go out on their own. You could find a running partner. I ran with Philip for a short amount of time while I was just like getting started with running. I don't anymore, I can run on my own just fine now because I've built the confidence up that way. But yeah, you can find a running partner, a friend that might want to build up their fitness, or someone else that might want to start running, join with them. Be social with your running. So there's places like Running Bug and Runner's World and UK Run Chat. I think they have a website, but they're also on Twitter, so you can use the hashtag UK Run Chat. And you can talk to other runners that way. They're really helpful. I've been joining in with their chats on Sunday, and you can talk to other people about running and races and any advice and stuff like that. And there's runners from all over the place with all different journeys and all fitness levels and all beginner runners, intermediate runners, advanced runners, and they all combine in the same place and talk about running. So that's it. That is my running story and my running tips. If you have any questions or anything like that about my running or what I do, or any questions at all about running, then please leave them below. If you have any suggestions for future videos on running or anything like that, or on yoga, health, fitness, weight loss, anything like that, please leave them in the comments. If you liked this video and you found it helpful, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you would like to see more videos, I put out a new video every week. But yeah, that's about it. Like I said, any comments, any questions, any comments, leave them below. Any ideas or anything like that, leave them below. Anything that I spoke about, like running shops, gait analysis, brands of shoes, anything like that, I will leave them in the description with links and stuff like that, so you can check them out. And that is it for this week. I hope you've all had a good week, and I will see you again next week. Bye!